Hello everyone and welcome. In this video, we'll be taking a look at one of the newest products we have in stock at CCL Components, which is the latest version of the Powerwall. To help me with this video, we have Gary Stirling, the UK country manager for Tesla residential energy products. I got that right.
Yeah? You did, yeah.
Fantastic. Gary, thanks for joining us today. If we can just get straight into it.
Yeah.
And can you give us an overview of the Powerwall 3, what's inside it and what can the system do?
Yeah, absolutely. So this is our new gen model that replaces Powerwall 2. Essentially what we've done is massively upgrade the power output compared to Powerwall 2. We've made it significantly easier to install, and we've also integrated our solar inverter in it as well. So we've massively ramped up how flexible it can be and bring as much as we possibly can into a single box.
Brilliant, yeah. So one of the biggest changes, as far as we understand, is between the Powerwall 3 and its predecessor, is the inbuilt PV
Correct.
Inverter in here. So could you give us a bit of an idea about the, well, can you tell us about the features of that?
Yeah,
inverter?
Sure. Yeah, so it's 11 kilowatt inverter in this. You can oversize your PV up to 20 kilowatts. Uh-huh. We have three MPPTs in here, so it gives you tons of flexibility in terms of how you design your system. You can go as low as 2 modules per string, as high as 15. So if you've got awkward roofs, tons of shading, just gives you a solution depending on what you're facing to cover as many possible installations as what you could possibly need.
Brilliant. So the key highlight is a lot of flexibility with this one. So
yep.
You've also mentioned that the inverter itself is not a fixed output.
Correct.
So that really simplifies the purchasing for an installer, as there is just one unit that is purchased and the output is set on site. How is that done?
Yeah, sure. So it's one SKU and we have multiple power ratings. So you can set it to 3.68 kilowatts, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11.04 kilowatts. All from a single box. When it comes to the commissioning on site, the installer selects the DNO permissions and the power approval, and the Powerwall will set itself to meet that. So it's one product fits all.
So a question that we have been getting is that just export limitation that's set, or is that the output of the inverter that is set as well?
Yeah, that's the output of the Powerwall. The export limitation is a different setting within
completely
the commissioning.
Separate.
Completely separate. So you just free type what you've been restricted to by the DNO, and that will take that into account when managing the flow of energy within the home.
Great, okay. So once these are initially installed by the installer, if at a later date the owner of the product wants to actually change those settings, is that possible?
Yeah, absolutely. We've had some sites already where that's been the case, where a customer's maybe been granted permission at 5 kilowatts and required more. All they have to do is share a copy of that approval from the DNO for the higher power output, and our support team can update that remotely, so there's no need to return to site from the installers.
Okay, great. So, right, let's move on to the next aspect of this, which would be the storage that's inside there. So we've got 13.5 kilowatt hours storage in there, which is a generous amount of storage anyways. Unlike the previous versions of the Powerwall, in order to get more storage, you don't have to parallel more units.
Correct.
So could you tell us about the storage options
absolutely.
That are available?
Yeah, absolutely. So Powerwall 2, we heard from customers often they maybe wanted a second unit, but they couldn't get DNO permission because of additional power electronics.
Right.
To get around this with Powerwall 3, we've developed our DC expansion packs. That allows customers to add an additional 13.5 kilowatt hours, but significantly cheaper, significantly easier, no DNO costs. We've manufactured a harness that plugs into the side of the unit.
Right.
It can take as little as 30 minutes to add an expansion unit onto a lead Powerwall 3, and you can stack them front to back or side by side. So you've got lots of flexibility in terms of how you want to expand your system and exactly how you want it to look based on space constraints on a site.
Absolutely, yeah, that's going to be one of the biggest restrictions is where is it going to go, I suppose, for the extra storage as well. So as for the storage, more storage is being put external to properties for various reasons, but in order to do that, they have to be protected against the elements. So considering that, could you tell us about the protection levels on here?
Yeah, of course, no problem. So yeah, Powerwall is IP67 rated, so straight out the box, it can go on an exterior wall. You don't need any additional items to make it suitable for outdoor installation. It's thermally managed to ensure we can operate in the harshest conditions. So it will operate up to 50 degrees and down to minus 20. Here in Glasgow, I've had it down to minus 16, so I've been pretty close myself.
And it will still keep going.
It will still keep
Fantastic.
Going, yeah. So we've got an embedded resistive heater on each individual cell, so it warms it very efficiently. It's also floodproof, up to 2 feet. So it's laser welded to ensure that you're not at risk if you have a customer who's in a flood zone, at risk of flooding,
Oh, no, that's amazing. So For extreme weather conditions,
you
have something called Stormwatch.
Yes.
So can you tell us how that feature works and what users could expect from it?
Yeah, no problem. So Stormwatch, very popular in America for us due to the storms they face, and we've brought that feature here to the UK. Essentially how it works is we link with the Met Office. If there's an amber or red weather warning, we will trigger Stormwatch and the Powerwalls in the affected area. Essentially what happens is it will fill the Powerwall to 100% for the duration of the storm. Once the storm passes, it resumes normal operation, but gives customers the comfort they've got a full battery there if they were to lose power.
Yeah, and that's an optional feature as well.
Can be you can opt in. Exactly, yeah. It's in the app, so customers, we feel most of them select it because it takes the pressure away of if there's a storm having to control their system. It's a peace of mind feature, but it's completely optional for each individual user.
Okay, so for the Powerwall 3 to provide backup power, it operates through the gateway.
Correct.
Now, are there any other additional features that has at all?
Yeah, essentially the gateway is primarily where the changeover happens if there's a loss in power, but there's a couple other things in there that'd be handy for installers to consider. You have the option of wiring backup and non-backup loads. Now, we find majority of customers go for whole home backup. Mm-hmm. However, when it comes to, if you've got especially heavy loads, maybe an EV charger or a hot tub, you can wire them into a non-backup load so they're not drawing power when there's a power outage. Also within the gateway at the bottom, there's a DIN rail that's completely available to the installers to use. If they want to put an EV charger in there, like that's just an extension, they can put whatever they want in, a free space for them.
Oh, fantastic, okay. So it does use the same gateway as the previous version, is that right?
That's right, yeah.
Fantastic, okay. So customers looking to upgrade from the old version to this version, is it just a straight swap or is there anything else that needs to be done?
Straight swap, so the gateway stays exactly the same and then it's the cabling, majority of the cabling from the gateway to the Powerwall can be kept the same as well. So it's very compatible with each other if you're upgrading from a 2 to a 3.
Now, we will get customers as well who are thinking about maybe they do want the Powerwall, but they don't necessarily need the backup or not looking for the backup at all.
Yep.
Is that going to be an option at all?
Yes, so we're going to bring that out very soon. Essentially, you'll have the option of whether or not you want backup. The Powerwall will be installed with what we have as the Tesla remote meter. Mm-hmm. That will monitor the loads of the home. It will do exactly the same features, just minus backup, but it will be considerably cheaper because it's a hardware saving and an install time and cost saving as well. So it will give customers a lower cost of entry into the Powerwall.
Right, okay. That's a great extra option there.
Yeah.
Right, when we receive this, I'm going to go to the actual look of the box and everything right now, because once we actually receive this, it's quite a unique box that we've got.
Yeah.
Can you tell us why it's designed in that way?
Yeah, sure. So we've built a new clamshell around Powerwall 3. It's hard plastic, and essentially what we want to do is reduce waste and make it stronger for transport as well. So it's a very strong plastic that encompasses all the components within the Powerwall 3. It's very strong, it can take my weight standing on top of it, and it ensures there's not any damage in transit. But the most important part of it really is it's fully recyclable. We want it back, we will reuse it for future Powerwalls, and it really drives our sustainability values. We're very focused on that, and it's just a way to reduce any kind of waste when deploying our products.
Right, okay. Moving on to the technology kind of side of it, Tesla is known for its software in particular. Now, the app itself, that's bringing together all the Tesla ecosystem, right?
That's right.
Could you tell us a little bit more about, say, some of the features that the end user would experience on the app?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, the app was designed to bring the entire ecosystem into one view. So you can see, you know, your vehicle, what it's charging at. You can see your wall connector, how that's operating, your solar generation, your home loads, Powerwall charge levels. So you can see exactly at a glance every way you're using energy within your home. One of the kind of really nice features we've got within Powerwall and the app is what we call OptiCaster, which is our AI software. And effectively that manages how you use energy in your home to keep your home running as low cost as possible. It will look at your user habits, it will look at weather forecasting, it'll look at what tariff you're on and make smart decisions to run your home, like I say, as cheap as possibly.
So it just takes over the functionality of without having to think.
Takes the guesswork away, exactly.
Fantastic. Yeah. Brilliant. So something that's probably an increasing something that customers are more increasingly aware of is a warranty mm-hmm. on the products. How does the warranty look like for the end user on the Tesla?
Yeah, so we're very focused on our warranty. You know, we have just built our 1 millionth Powerwall over in Nevada. So you know, you get to that number by having reliable products, and our warranty backs that up. We have 10 years mm-hmm. unlimited charge cycles, right. takes all the guesswork out of that, 100% depth of discharge. If any point it drops below 80% energy retention, we'll give you a new system. It really is that simple.
Wow.
It's two pages, no jargon. It starts from the day of commissioning. There's no additional steps. It genuinely couldn't be easier.
Brilliant. And I suppose for the installer as well then, if, for instance, there is an issue with a Powerwall, what does the RMA process look like?
Sure.
Is that direct through Tesla?
Direct through us, yeah. So we manage all the RMA process. If there is the rare case of a fault, we will handle all the return of the faulty unit back to ourselves to be recycled. And we will supply the parts. And one of the unique things about our warranty is it's actually a full 10-year warranty and labour, parts and labour warranty. So we actually pay our engineers to return to site so they're not left out of pocket if a part was to fail.
Brilliant. Yeah. Okay, that's always reassuring for the installer as well. Absolutely. Okay, so speaking about the installers, they all have to be approved Tesla installers.
Yeah.
So how would someone go around getting into the training process?
Yeah, absolutely. So like you say, you need to be a partner of ours to access the training. You can apply through our website on the Partner with Tesla section. We run training sessions constantly. We have virtual online training on our partner portal, so you can do the training at your own leisure. We run roadshows in our stores across the country. We also have an account management team who are across the UK who can come and visit you. And last but not least, we have our field trainer. His role is to travel the country with a van, kitted out with Powerwall gear, showing you how it's installed. So there are plenty of options to make sure you're getting the support you need from a training perspective.
There's lots of opportunity to get the right training.
Exactly.
To be able to put these in correctly into properties.
Yeah. Exactly.
Fantastic. Okay, great. Well, thanks very much for joining us today, Gary. It's been great to have a really good insight into the Powerwall. For anyone watching at home, if you're considering installing the Powerwall and still have questions, drop us a comment below. Alternatively, you can reach out to the sales team at CCL Components for more information, or if you are looking for a quote and want to discuss that further, please get in contact. We'll see you next time.